Yumba District remains one of the worst performing districts, according to the recently released PLE, UCE, and USCE exam results. The rate of school dropouts and absentees remains equally high in the district. Recent statistics indicated that last year, over 35,000 children enrolled in school for primary one. However, only 17,000 of them made it to primary two, and majority of them have since dropped out.
In P2, they are dropping away from school. How can you manage such a group of people, honestly? So, this is where we have a very big problem. By the time we reach P7, the people, we will only have 3,000 in P7 out of 34. But they talk about the performance of these 3,000 will be by everybody in town. The DO is useless, the teachers are useless, the what? What about the 32,000 who did not reach P7 and are with them at home?
Some of the children have engaged in scrap picking, hawking snacks, among others. Leaders say this has also led to a rise in early marriages and teenage pregnancies.
2023, where elsewhere, everybody knows I produce, I need school. During the education conference, one of our presenters told us, and people thought he was bragging, eh? He said, these days, education is not a service that you think you need it free. Education now is business.
Kaya Lunes, the Yumba District Education Officer, says many parents claim that government schools are very far, in addition to the overwhelming number of refugees in the district who are competing for the same facilities.
First, with the design of this project by Labe, because just as I said, it looks at the family where this child comes from. Just as I had said, this child must be, the parents must be able to provide. It looks at when this child is at the ECD center, the caregivers, the environment, and so on, even the level of skills that these caregivers have, so that when this child is there, is able to receive a maximum, you see, services that is from trained caregivers.
Our learners don't go through the ECD. And therefore, the foundation at ECD is not now inculcated into them. They go direct to the primary just for the sake of going, but the interest may not be there. Because when somebody goes through ECD, it inculcates interest. That learner becomes, you know, through play and many other things. So maybe through play matters, which is now coming into our system, where in the primary, they're also trying to introduce play. I think through that, maybe our retention will improve.
Leaders have welcomed the Literacy and Adult Basic Education, LABE, through a Kulea Watoto project aimed at improving access to basic education within refugee hosting districts. Under this arrangement, parents will also be trained on how they can pass on literacy skills to their children.
Bringing parents to be actively involved in the preparation of their children for school readiness. We are aware that most parents, especially in rural areas, do not have access to formal nursery schools where children would be getting such services. So what we do is to prepare parents to identify anyone home where they can create a space where activities like ECD can take place.
Kulea Watoto, a joint project will be implemented in three districts of Yumbe, Kampala, and Chenjejo that are hosting refugees, where literacy and adult basic education, LABE, shall handle Yumbe. Rachel Natwala for the news.